to Microsoft Dataverse. Before starting, I want to say that I'm proud to have the opportunity to propose this session in this fantastic event. Thanks, Raz, for this opportunity. Who I am? My name is Mark Rock, and I'm a customer engineer in Microsoft Italy. For people that don't know me, I live in Milan, in the north of the Italy. What is this role customer engineer in Microsoft? Is the role that before the last reorg in Microsoft last July 2020 was called the Premier Field Engineer. What I do, I work with SharePoint since 2008 as a developer. I started with SharePoint 2007 and I followed all SharePoint on-prem evolution from 2007, 10, 13, etc. And now I work mainly with SharePoint online. But today is not enough work with SharePoint. In fact, SharePoint is connected with more modern workplace application present in Microsoft 365, such as OneDrive, Forms, Stream, and now, for example, in Microsoft List. Obviously, like everyone who works in the modern workplace, today it's not possible not to work with Teams. But in the last 3 years, I'm focusing on Power Platform sector, and in particular mode, I'm focusing on Power Apps, Power Automate, and Power Virtual Agent. On the right of this slide, you can find my mail and my social links, Twitter and LinkedIn. Feel free to contact me for every question and curiosity about Power Platform in general. I have no problem to respond to all community member. Okay. The agenda of this session in short and easy, as you can see in this slide. At the beginning, I would like to imagine a new world. A new world where there is a new way of working for frontline worker. After, I want to offer you an introduction about the new model that you have to integrate Power Apps, Power Automate, Power Virtual Agent in Teams. And in fact, at the end, I follow with a mention how it's possible integrate not only App and Flow, but also Power Virtual Agent within the Teams. And at the end, the classic Q&A section. Okay, imagine a new world. How today frontline work in the past. But in many cases, even today, not only in the past. The response is very, very simple and is made in only two words, the old way, in the old way. In fact, today, in many realities, different company also in Italy work in the same mode, we see that the users work in a disconnected way. Still using system such as VPN to access corporate data and application. In many cases, all the data of this application are fragmented in the sense that is difficult to have applications that allow you to have a complete view of all data available. Not only, as you can see in this slide, they work using legacy app and device that can only run within the corporate infrastructure, still using many manual process, then dedicate a lot of time and resource to carry out repetitive task that now today could be automated, for example, using Power Automate. One of the most frequent case concern, for example, the archiving of document or classic approval process. But today it's possible to create a completely different way of working, where it's possible to integrate application and process, where it's possible to share application and content with the users who belong to different organizations, and where it's possible to automate even repetitive tasks. And all of these within a single hub, only into a single hub that also allow the users to communicate via chat or call, or where it's possible, organize a meeting. Today, as we know, this hub exists and is called Microsoft Teams. Microsoft Teams today is the hub for the modern workplace collaboration for Microsoft. But not only, because today is the time for a new challengers. Challengers that have completely changed, especially in the last year, for example, caused by COVID-19 emergency. For example, one of these challenges is that we need applications that respond quickly to the request of our customer. Customer could be internal in my organization or external customer if I'm a partner. Application that allow a rapid development and deployment time. Then it's important to reduce the development time, but not only it's important to reduce the deployment time. And above all, they allow saving both in terms of resource and investment. The money today is very, very important. For this, it's necessary to have an application platform as complete as possible. Microsoft Power Platform was created specifically to meet the challenge listed above. So we already have a low-code, no-code platform that allow you to quickly develop application using Power Apps, create approval process using Power Automate, define a report to existing data using Power BI, and create a chatbot with Power Virtual Agent. But the most important thing is that it's possible to create all of these things without technological skills. Then this platform is based, as we know, on a series of elements such as connector, the possibility to creating no-code portal, artificial intelligence, etc. Then for the citizen developer, today it's possible to use all of these components to create a custom application. But today we have another big problem. Microsoft Teams within an organization has already become the main platform for teamwork, a platform within the all user chat, organize meeting, organize live event, share content, etc. But at the same time, the same organization have started to create many applications, for example, with the Power Apps based on different type of data, SharePoint data, SQL data, Oracle data, etc. So today, one of the big challenges is to support customer in this process of transforming existing application that the customer have based on Power Power Apps and integrate them into Microsoft Teams. But how is possible complete this process? It's possible trying to create an application platform that is natively incorporated into Teams. Okay, it's very, very important this. I need to have a platform where it is easy to create a new application and therefore easy the creation of the user interface and the connection to the backend system. Okay, and where you can have a lot of template available to help the adoption phase. Okay, that where, for example, you have a template for the issue tracking application. I don't have the necessary skill to create an application from scratch. I can use this template. This platform needed to facilitate the deployment process of application once they are built. For example, must be simple for the partner build and deploy solution for the customer. And the last point, this platform will be easy to manage. This mean clear governance could be a first important point and have I think I know that is a critical point, this, and must have an easy license model for Power Platform. I know that is too complex for the customer. Then, with this new platform, Microsoft would help the customer to simplify the license model. For this was born Microsoft Dataverse and Microsoft Dataverse for Teams. Microsoft Dataverse for Teams deliver a built-in low-code data platform for Microsoft Teams. Okay, is a specific data platform for Microsoft Teams and provide a relational data storage, rich data type, enterprise grade of governance, and a one-click solution deployment. Dataverse for Teams enable everyone to easily build and deploy app flow chatbot in Teams with the classic platform Power Apps, Power Automate, and Power Virtual Agent. Microsoft Dataverse for Teams is focused on low code, no code development. For this, certain capabilities such as developer API access and plugin support for the moment are not available. Okay, but you can find this feature only in Microsoft. In Microsoft Dataverse. And the second point, sorry, I need to return to my previous slide. The second point is that team users have today an embedded app studio for create app directly in Teams. And all app have already associated database on Microsoft Dataverse. That is not necessary, as in the past, open Power App Web Studio, create my app, then deploy this app in team and create all necessary connector. No, in the new mode, using Dataverse for Teams, the user have an embedded development environment in Teams and have already associated a database based on Microsoft Dataverse. With this built-in data platform and easy to use data editable data table, there is no need to connect to another storage because all data necessary for the application are in directly in the Teams. Okay, all users after this can now create custom data table that are, and this is very important, team and scenario specific. Okay, this table is for my team. Other teams have associated another database. In fact, to implement all of this feature, Microsoft Dataverse for Teams create a single environment for each Microsoft team where you can create data, app, automate, chatbot, etc. But what are the differences between Dataverse for Teams and Teams? As you can see in the slide, into the next, we have differences at every level. Okay. For example, regarding the environment, it's important this difference. In Dataverse for Teams, a new environment is created for each team. The first time an application associated to the team is created. While in Dataverse, it's possible to create an unlimited environment, a number of environments, having the appropriate capacity. Okay, this is important. Also, and in the second point, regarding the maximum size, pay attention to how many records you can save in Dataverse for Teams. At the moment, you have the ability to save 1 million row or 2 gigabytes of data. Another important aspect concerns the opportunity of easily integrated Dataverse with other systems. In this moment, for Dataverse for Teams, the only way that you have is using Power Automate. Okay, the third section of this slide. In Dataverse, you have a lot of way to integrate other services. For example, it's possible using a data export service, Azure Service Bus services, etc. Last, as you can see in this slide, it's not possible using API to create custom application that interact with Dataverse for Teams at the moment. Furthermore, only in Dataverse for Teams, there are some features such as an advanced search and last row of the slide, the opportunity of developing application that allow you to work in offline mode. Then offline mode is only for Microsoft Dataverse and is not available for Dataverse for Teams. Okay, in this slide, you can see all capability included in Dataverse for Teams. For a short recap, regarding environment lifecycle, as I previously mentioned, Dataverse for Teams create a single environment.
Hello there. Hello, Marco. Hello, Marco. Yes, if you just unmute yourself, that'd be great. Sorry. Awesome. Fantastic. Yes, please. Yeah. Awesome. Fantastic.
Okay.
Thanks, Marco.
Okay,
that's great.
Perfect.
Thank you.
I need to return to the previous slide. You see, you can hear me. Can you you follow this slide, or I need to return to this point?
Hi, Marco. Yes, we just lost you for the last minute. If you could just carry on from a minute ago, that'd be great.
Okay.
Thanks.
Perfect. Okay. Okay. Perfect. In this slide, you can see all capability included in Dataverse for team. For a short recap, regarding environment, for example, as I previously mentioned, Dataverse for Teams create a single environment for each team where you create data, app, etc. This environment supports backup feature, point in time restore, and disaster recovery procedure. To make the management easier, the lifecycle of Dataverse environment is connected to the associated Microsoft team. Okay, then if the team is deleted, its associated environment is also deleted. Okay, regarding the data section, Dataverse for Teams include relational data, image, and file. The 2 GB of capacity provide to a team, the team can typically store 1 million row of data. For the application lifecycle management, the same feature that you have in the Power platform, then it's possible to use a solution to move and to create an application. But to facilitate the adoption of Dataverse for Teams, it is possible to use for the users the solution already present in out-of-the-box mode. Among those, you can find asset management, for example, employee ideas, issue reporting. But when you decide to use this application, Dataverse automatically create the table necessary for the application and the associated form for the application. Then, for example, in my organization, I can start at time zero to use, for example, issue reporting into my teams. In the same mode, customer partner can deploy a custom solution after my partner add the solution in my environment. Users can add the solution in just in few click. Okay, but it's important to understand what's happened about the security and governance. Security and governance in Dataverse for Teams is very, very easy because it's based on Microsoft Teams. In fact, the access is pre-configured with a security rule based on a team membership. Then you have only owner, member, and guest. It's not complex as, for example, in classic Dataverse, where you have a lot of rules for manage the security. Then the security and governance in Dataverse for Teams is based on the team, the same team, okay? But after this, both Dataverse and Dataverse for Teams include support, for example, for activity logging. One of the best feature is who create a record, while only Dataverse provide additional capability for auditing. It's okay, as you can see in this slide. Finally, in this slide, I summarize general pro and cons between Dataverse for Teams and Dataverse. In conclusion, until 1 million of raw or 2 gigabyte limit per Teams, and if your app live totally in team, then live in the team context, today Dataverse for Teams could be a valid option to create a business application within team. What's mean this? This means that it's not necessary, as in the past, create a custom SharePoint list where I need to save my data. I have already a classic database out of the box in my team where it's possible to save my data. Obviously, if it is necessary to use greater integration, okay, towards other system, for example, SQL Server, SAP, Oracle, it's necessary to use a premium connector, and therefore it will not possible to remain within Dataverse for Teams. Okay. I start with my first demo. This is my classic, I'm in Microsoft Teams. You can see the web version, but the desktop version is in the same. I can add today, for example, search Power Apps, okay? I have already pinned Power Apps application in my Teams. Then I can start to create a new application, okay? The first option is select a team where I want to deploy my app. Okay, I can select my team. The first time, this environment was created. Okay, then you can see a new environment with a different type. The classic type are production, default, trial, sandbox, etc. Now you can see a new type, Microsoft Teams. Then what's this mean? That this environment is associated to one team. Okay, I need to select my name of my app. Okay. After this, I need to create or using existing table in my environment. Today, the environment is very, very slow. Okay. If not, I use another. I have already prepared other application. Okay, but oh my God! Sorry for this. For this issue. Okay. I switch to the build section. In the build section, I see all of my application. Okay, I try to reopen my sample to app. Okay. As you can see, now I have a Power Apps Studio environment with my teams. Then it's possible, it's a classic Power App web tool. Then I can add a lot of control, create several screens for my application. Okay, well, then I can create, for example, a new table. Okay. Product to sample. Okay. This is my table name. Then after this, I can create rename edit column product name, the type, I can choose the type of my data, because I have a lot of type of column, product type. For example, I can choose a choice. So, well, I can select the color for different choice. Okay, product cost a number or decimal. I have advanced option, max value. I can set max value. Okay. Etc. I have a lot of column. Close, the table is automatically saved. Okay. And the table is automatically associated to my application. In my app, I already have a screen with a gallery and the screen for the tail. Okay, I can select my table. Okay, then I can change all parameter about my application. Okay, then it's possible customize this form. Okay, then add, for example, a lot of table in okay, then in the same way that you use in classic Power App Web Studio. Then I can select the correct gallery. Okay. Then I can, using the preview, new record, product name. Product type, hardware, product cost. Okay, this is the list of my product, and this is the detail the tail form. After this, I need only to save my application. Okay, save and publish to Teams. Okay. This one, at the moment, I have two channel in my Teams, general channel and geofeature channel. I want to add my new application as a new tab in my channel. Okay, then I need only to save and close this form. If I switch to my Teams, okay, you can see my app directly in my Teams. Okay, it's very, very easy. Create an application and deploy it in my team channel as a tab. Okay, just using a few click. Okay, in this version of Power Up Studio, you can see it's not only useful for create application, but you can manage all elements that you have in this environment. For example, entities, chatbot, and Power Automate object. Oh my God. Oof. Sorry for this delay. I apologize. But today the network is not good. Just to reopen the team tab. Okay. In the build section, okay, I can click see all, then I can see all elements that I have in my project Octel introduction environment. Then I can see all of my chatbot and Power Automate. But for them, you can create more complex application. For example, this app is a show video that is based on multimedia content. Then I can connect this app with a RSS feed service that import in my table feed and feed items a lot of content based on a classic video library about Power Platform community. Okay, I can, for example, edit data of my table. Then I can change the structure or I can edit directly the data in my application. Okay, I can start the preview. Okay. This is the media content in my application. After I create this application, I can publish to the Teams, and the result is that directly in my channel I can consume this app. Okay, but there are no data in other system, all data are only in a table in the same environment of the same team. This is very, very, very important. Okay, I return to my presentation because as a Power App Studio embedded, we are using Power Virtual Agent portal embedded in Teams, users can now easily and quickly build a chatbot with drag and drop simplicity, as you can already know, in Teams without switching application. Then it's possible create, you need only to add a Power Virtual Agent application for Teams, in Teams, and you can start to create a chatbot. But remember that you can only build, publish and use chatbot with Team native experience. This means that if you need to access a premium connector and host intelligent bot externally from Teams, you need to pass to Power Virtual Agent standalone plan. It's not possible to use Power Virtual Agent for Microsoft Dataverse. Okay, but how is possible create chatbot? Okay, we have another application. Okay, I can select Power Virtual Agent app. Okay, in the same mode, I can start to create a new chatbot. Okay, the first option is select a team. Okay, then I can start to create a new chatbot, or I can see existing chatbot that I already have in my environment. Oh my God. Okay. For example, I can edit this chatbot. Development environment is the same as the classic Power Virtual Agent Studio. Then I go to the topics. For example, I can modify this my first topic. I can add, for example, a trigger phrase. I can go to save topic. Then I can go to authoring phase. Okay. Then I can continue to modify my chatbot. I can test the bot, or after this, I can publish it in Teams. Okay. Publish my bot, open the bot using Teams. Add. Good morning. Another trigger phrase. Okay. Then I can use my chatbot Dart in Teams. It's very, very, very easy. Okay, I finished my presentation, and before moving to any question, I want to thank all of attendee of your attention. Thanks for all, guys.
Thank you, Marco, for that very that demo of Dataverse for Teams, right? So that was a really good hands-on demo. Not only did you compare the features that you get with Dataverse for Teams, but also showed it in action, which is really good to see. Let's take a look at questions now, guys.
I love SharePoint list. Sure, SharePoint continue to is to exist. It's very, very important for as a data platform for our application. But for a lot of users, SharePoint is not easy to use. It's too complex, and several customers prefer to move in Dataverse, and Dataverse not have a problem, for example, regarding delegation issue, because is a relational database. SharePoint list is not a relational database. This is the mainly feature that you have today in Microsoft Dataverse. And the difference regarding the Microsoft list.
Okay, do we have any other questions? I know there's lots of features there and a lot of overlap. And this is definitely going to change the way we use, traditionally use SharePoint.
For the moment, not exist an easy way to populate the table because not have a service as you have in a classic Dataverse. For example, import in Excel. At the moment, the only way is copy and paste from Excel to data grid view in Dataverse, but is a work in progress for the moment. No, it's not possible using to Azure SQL, because Azure SQL need a premium connector. Sure, I can save my slide in PDF and I can share with you. Okay, Kim, but all are premium connector. Then it's not possible using Dataverse for the moment. Okay, not exist the enforcement of the license, okay? Then works, but is not supported, because you need to have a premium connector to use Azure SQL on Azure from Power Automate, Power Virtual Agent, or other application. No, Dataverse is a separated license, okay? But Dataverse 14 not need a separate license. It's completely included in your Teams license. But instead, classic Dataverse needed a premium license for the connector. Okay, we have a lot of questions. Understand, Kim, the feature is only a limitation with the license. Sure. Okay, that's I save my presentation in PDF and I'll share with you. Could be okay.
That would be great. Yes, and feel free to share it in the Teams chat if you have a link. Otherwise, yeah, we're happy to share it on the community page, on the community portal, powercommunity.com. We can share it across there as well. Right, so we've covered a lot today, right? So we've already covered Dataverse for Teams, and thanks again for showing the comparisons, which is often very, very important. There's lots of gray areas, and I know a lot of big topic was on licensing as well today. You mentioned, you emphasized on the differences between the premium connectors and what you get with Dataverse for Teams. So thanks again for all of that. So Marco, do you have any final comments before we finish this session?
Not for my side.
Well, thank you, Marco. Thanks again for joining us today.
I hope to see you again live, not virtually at some upcoming event. I hope this year to see you again live. I think that is important for the community.
Oh, definitely. Yes, I think we're all itching to attend in person again and meet one another. You know, and have a real connection with one another. That's always really good, and I really appreciate everyone's contributions continued throughout COVID. But once again, it's always a great pleasure, Marco. So thanks again.
Bye. Thanks for all.